In this video, we're finding the indefinite integral of x cubed over the square root of 2 minus x squared. And this is one of those cases where I think an explicit u-substitution is absolutely necessary. Oftentimes, u-substitutions are guessable by just looking at the chain rule backwards. But when you have these square roots involved, it's not really true. And the general strategy here is let's try letting the interior of the square root be u, and then just hope for the best. So I'm going to let u equal 2 minus x squared. I should point out here, for those of you a little further along in calculus, that a trig substitution will also work for this problem, but it is possible by using a u substitution instead. So we move along with our u sub, and we get the differential of u. So we take the derivative of it and multiply by dx. That's negative 2x dx. Now I can see in my numerator that I could split off an x out of that x cubed, and that would give me an x dx, which basically gets the job done. But then I'm left with an extra x squared up there. So I'm going to prepare for that by going back to my original substitution and solving for x squared. And that's 2 minus u. So when I find that x squared in the integral, I'm going to replace it with 2 minus u. So let's get the transformation done. Again, my numerator can be split up where I get that x out of the x cubed and I use that to build the differential, negative 2x dx. And I'm going to go ahead and throw a factor of negative 2 in there right now. And I compensate out in front by putting a negative 1/2. And then my denominator is just the square root of 2 minus x squared, which becomes the square root of u in the next step. So I have a negative 1/2 integral of x squared, but that's just 2 minus u. And then negative 2x dx, that's du. And then in my denominator is the square root of u, which I'm going to write as u to the 1/2, because I can see what's coming next. What I want to do is split up the integrand into two terms. I have 2 divided by u to the 1/2, and that's 2u to the negative 1/2. And then I have a minus u divided by u to the 1/2, so a minus u to the 1/2. These are each power functions where we can just use the power rule for antiderivatives to get the antiderivative. So I have a negative 1/2 times, and then the antiderivative of u to the 1/2, you just add 1 to the exponent and divide by the result. So that's u to the 1/2 divided by 1/2. Dividing by 1/2 is the same as multiplying by 2, so I have 4u to the 1/2. The second term is u to the 3/2 divided by 3/2, which is the same as multiplying by 2/3. So minus 2/3 u to the 3/2 plus some arbitrary constant. And then to finish the problem, I need to sub in the definition of u in terms of x. And I'll go ahead and clean things up a little. I'm going to distribute the negative 1/2 to both of these terms. For the first term, negative 1/2 of 4, that's negative 2 u to the 1/2. The second term, negative 1/2 times 2/3, that's positive 1/3 u to the 3/2. And again, I have an arbitrary constant. Now you might complain I just multiplied c by negative 1/2, but it's an arbitrary constant. So when I multiply it by negative 1/2, I just get another arbitrary constant. Finally, I need to sub in the original definition of u in terms of x. So I get negative 2, and I'm going to use a square root instead of a power of 1/2 because it looks better. And u was 2 minus x squared. And then I have a plus 1/3 times the quantity 2 minus x squared to the 3/2 plus an arbitrary constant. Now there are ways you can manipulate this solution. I could factor a square root of 2 minus x squared out of both of those terms, but the way the answer is at this point is acceptable, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.